Today, the church puts us to celebrate into the Holy Cross and to remind us the meaning of the cross in our life. But also, today in Taiwan, in all the Chinese world, in this week, from Monday, Tuesday, it is the day for the dead, the day to clean the graves. So I wanted to say a few things about the cross and about the death. Because, you know, the cross, from one point of view, it is the symbol of the death. But, but Jesus Christ changed this meaning and made the cross the symbol of the real life. And I wanted now to say to you a few things about what is the point of the real life. Because if life is only my individuality, that I am here, different from you, I'm not you, this is already death. The real life comes first from the death on the individuality. And this is the meaning of the cross. And this is actually why the people, I think we can, I mean, this is why we can give a new meaning to the, you know, memorial services and to the care of the Chinese people for the dead. The ancient Greek philosophers, Plato, was saying that philosophy is the study of the death. Well, from one point of view, this is correct. But from the other point of view, for a Christian, it's not correct. Because we don't study the death, we study the life. We study Jesus Christ as life. The death is the ultimate enemy of us. God did not create the death. You must remember this. The death came because of the fall, and because this fall is what? It's not that we break a commandment, but we prefer to put our individuality and to live the opposite way of the Holy Trinity, which is life in communion. But, you know, the love is more than the death. We see this everywhere, and I am so moved that the Chinese people, in all Chinese areas, all over the world, they remember their dead people. They refuse to accept that they are separated. They refuse to accept that the death prevails. And what is the death? Most of it is the separation, right? This is why death is terrible, because he separates us from what we love, from our beloved ones, and it separates us also from the world. I cannot touch, right? And my body is destroyed. But it is the love of the others that they don't allow me to die. This is very important. It is not that God created, as Plato and other philosophers say, immortal souls. Nothing is immortal. But it is by the grace of God. The angels also are not immortal, but the grace of God does not allow them to die. It's a gift that God does not take back, this gift. Even the devils, God does not take back this gift of life. He gave life forever. It's okay. But it is very important to understand that the death is the very big enemy which can help us to rethink about our love. Because, you know, what's the big death, the biggest death? Not before the death, before the death. The separation, right? The break of love, right? People are married, and then, you know, something happens. It's not important who is responsible. Both are responsible. The love is broken. Is this a death? Of course it is a death. More painful many times than the biological death. So we live in this death. And, you know, finally it comes also the death as total separation of the others. And first it is the grace of God that does not allow us to become zero and keeps something from us. This is what we call soul, which has consciousness. But it is also something more, that the love of the people, the love of our beloved ones, does not allow us to die. You see, today and tomorrow and all this week, the Chinese people, they will go to clean the tombs. For what? Because of the poor and the pure love. Because the dead person, you know, is not there. And why we do this? Somebody will say, what are you doing? You waste your time. But it's not to waste your time. It's the most beautiful thing. Because the body was there, or the essence was there. And we saw our humble love, because we cannot do anything more. And we can do many things, actually. And Chinese people do many things when they pray for the dead every twice a month, right? They offer some things. And this is what we did today. We did the liturgy, and in the liturgy there is no death. We commemorate our dead people. We have the small pieces of bread, and their souls came. And they are full of love and full of glory. They are in the kingdom of heaven, in the second coming of Jesus Christ, which happens in the liturgy, in every liturgy. And the liturgy is what? The celebration of life, of Jesus Christ as life, of Jesus Christ as food of life, and as a source of life. And what is this life? The ultimate love. Because Jesus enters to my body and to your body, and nobody can enter so deeply. And this is what? The ultimate love, right? Which is love. And this love is not only for me, it's for all of you, because Jesus makes us one, because we take his body, and we have something not imaginary, not spiritual. There are no spiritual things in the church. Real. It's the body of Jesus Christ. Not only the faith of Jesus Christ, but the body of Jesus Christ, which unites us and makes us one. And it is very important to see that in front of the source of life, who is Jesus Christ, we pray for our departed. In the church, we don't say dead, there is no death. We say departed people, sleeping, because Jesus changed the death. And in every liturgy is the celebration of life, is the celebration where our dead people that we commemorate, we give the names to the priest to take a small piece of bread. And when the priest blesses the bread and the wine, this time you should, everybody, say in your minds, the names of the dead people. God is listening this time. And they are here, and they are happy. And St. Nicholas Kavasimas says, we don't know, of course, maybe they received the Holy Communion by other way of God, because there is no reason not to receive. So, you know, this is really a very good incident that we celebrate the cross. Because what is the cross, as I say? The death of the individuality. And if we think that my death, which will come soon, it is the participation of the death, of the mystery of death, which is so bad, of all these human beings, of the people who suffer. And the ultimate suffering is not the cancer, is not the pain, is the separation from those we love. This is the ultimate pain, and from all this beautiful universe. This is why we will resurrect. God did not say, well, you will live like spirits. No, it's very bad. We will resurrect and take our bodies, much more beautiful, without any need, full of love and light, to enjoy every simple creature, every molecule of the creation. And we can see something with the death, that when my body will dissolve as flesh or ashes, it will be united with other things, right? With the dust, with the the rain will come. Maybe some, you know, flowers will absorb this and make it like a vitamin. And so my body will be, you know, again, united, as cannot be now. Now I take the things and I made them food and I made them my life. Now they will make me food. And this is, from one point of view, very moving. The pure and humble love that we owe to the creation and that we owe to each other. And again I say that the love is more than the death. And this is the most important thing to celebrate, to say about the celebration of the cleaning, the tools, this thing that the Chinese people do, and they go there and they pray and they show their respect as they can, because they cannot do more. But here is the more. And this is what we do. And as I say, because I'm not a good priest, I pray for everybody. And I don't care so much about, you know, some restrictions. And this is the point that we do here, the liturgy. We are so small community, but we have so much grace of God. To bring the grace of God in the land of Taiwan, in the Chinese culture, and to say, oh, these days for the Chinese, we not only clean the tombs outside, we send so much grace of God to this place, the place that the last things, the last bones, I mean the bones and the ashes of my beloved, of our beloved people are there. And this makes our people happy, the living and the dead. And that we are here for them, to pray for them. Nobody prays so deeply than the Orthodox Church. In every liturgy, this is the real commemoration. This is the real prayer of the dead. It's not the Koriva. Koriva is a small thing when we have this. The real one is during the Divine Liturgy. What I want all of us to remember is really that the love overcomes the death. When we love, and God loves, this is why there is no death, because God loves permanently and instantly. And how to love our dead people? This is a very important thing. It's to remember them, not to let them die in our minds. This is the first thing. I experienced so much the death of somebody who doesn't want me to be alive and in the university. And this is killing me. So to keep somebody alive in your mind is very important. But more important is not to keep it as your possession. It's not like my mobile telephone, it's mine. Your memories, they don't only belong to you. You share this memory with God. You share it, this memory, to be much more deeper and to put God inside, because God is life. We think that God is helping us and this, but this is nothing. The real life is this connection. Life is not that I exist, just I exist, no matter what. If you take out this connection, this communion, this is the death. The devil exists, of course. But this is why, this is his hell, that he exists without connection, without communion. So God is life, and he gives us the life as communion, as connection. So when we remember and we do something for our dead people, we involve God there and we present them to God. And God is uniting us with him, and we make a big bosom. And this big bosom is the greatest commemoration, is the greatest prayer. It's not prayer. Our beloved people know this. They are very happy. And we sometimes feel it. Sometimes there is no need to feel, because God does not allow us. Maybe we will say, oh, I am a medium, I am, you know, like a psychic or something, and I will misuse this kind of power. But, you know, we must know that this exists. And this is the message that we give to our brothers and sisters, that we did this liturgy, and all this week, that the grace of God will go not only to the graves, but to unite again, and reunite, and forgive any sad things, sorrows, mistakes that our dead people have done to us, or we have done to them. And to be again united much more strongly, waiting the resurrection, waiting where we will be all together very strongly, one in the grace of Jesus Christ. Thank you for being protected of us. We have a lot of food. Ah, not to forget to say to you about our application. If you search